Final Cut Pro is great, but if you're not using these five modern tools alongside it, you're leaving speed and quality on the table. From AI-assisted editing and content brainstorming, to mastering your audio, designing custom motion graphics, and even archiving entire projects, these apps have completely changed the way I work. Whether you're making YouTube videos or delivering polished content for clients, they'll save you time, simplify your process, and seriously boost your production value. First up is ChatGPT, and honestly, I use this more than any other tool in my workflow. This is usually where every video starts. I'll open it up and just start tossing around ideas. It's kind of like bouncing stuff off a friend. I'll ask, would this make a good video? Or what are some different ways I could cover this topic? It helps me figure out if something's actually worth making. Once I've landed on a topic, I usually write the script myself, but then I'll bring ChatGPT back to help clean it up. I use it to cut out all the fluff, make sure I'm not rambling, and keep the tone and point of view consistent throughout. Basically helps me sound like me, but tighter and more to the point. Then, once the script's done, I'll ask it to come up with some title and thumbnail ideas. This part is actually super helpful. If I can't come up with a solid hook or something visually interesting, I usually take that as a sign that the video might not be worth doing. I also use it to write video descriptions and come up with all the tags. What's nice is it remembers all the links I include in every video description, so I don't have to copy and paste them every single time. That saves me a ton of time, especially when I got affiliate links, plugin links, and services I always recommend. So yeah, ChatGPT, a big part of my process, from idea to upload. Once the idea is solid and I've got a script I'm happy with, I'll go ahead and shoot the talking head part, grab any screen recordings I need, and get all the B-roll out of the way. Now, here's the thing. I mess up a lot when I talk to the camera. There's a ton of pauses, retakes, and stuff I know I'll cut out later. Instead of spending hours scrubbing through all that myself, I just upload the raw footage to Gling and let AI handle it. It edits my A-roll automatically, cuts out all the dead space, mistakes, fillers, pretty much anything that doesn't need to be there. Is it perfect? No, but it gets me about 90% of the way there. After that, I'll just go in, make a few corrections if I need to, and export everything as a Final Cut Pro Multicam XML file. Then I import that into Final Cut Pro and keep editing from there. I still have full creative control over the final video. It just saves me from doing the boring, repetitive stuff. Gling basically speeds up the worst part of editing, which lets me focus on actually making a better video. Number three is Apple Motion. Now, I don't use Motion on every project, but anytime I need a custom title or motion graphic I don't already have, this is my go-to. Here's how I usually use it. While I'm editing in Final Cut, if I know I'm going to need a custom title, I'll just drop in a basic title and type in whatever text I need. Nothing fancy, just a placeholder. Then, once my edit is locked, I'll jump into Motion and actually build out the custom title. I'll publish it to Final Cut Pro, and then just drag and drop it over the placeholder title I made earlier. What's awesome is that the text I typed in originally carries over to the new custom title, so I don't have to retype anything or mess around with timing. It just works. And honestly, Motion is way more powerful than Final Cut Pro when it comes to building titles and effects. Tons of flexibility, and you can make things look exactly the way you want. It's one of those tools I don't always need, but when I do, I'm glad I have it. Before I export my final video, I always run my audio through Auphonic. I actually love this tool so much, I made a dedicated video about it. It's one of those behind-the-scenes apps that makes a huge difference in the final quality. I mainly use it to polish my dialogue, so stuff like removing background noise and reverb, cutting out little mouth clicks or breath, and just cleaning everything up. But the biggest reason I use it is for mastering. Auphonic sets all my levels properly, balances everything out, and brings the overall volume so it's optimized for YouTube. It saves me from having to mess around with limiters and compressors inside Final Cut, and honestly, it just sounds better. The last app I use is Arctic by Hedge. I don't actually touch it until after the video has been uploaded. Once the video is live on YouTube, that's when I go back and clean things up. I use Arctic to tidy up my Final Cut Pro library before I archive the project. If you've seen my previous media management video, you already know I like to keep things clean. And this is a big part of that. Over the course of a project, your library gets filled with extra stuff. Unused media, render files, backups, Architect helps me strip all that out without messing anything up. Once it's cleaned up, I archive my project to my NAS, so if I ever need to come back to it, everything's there, exactly how I left it, and nothing bloated or broken. This step isn't flashy, but it keeps my drives organized and saves me a ton of space long term. And if you want more detail on how I archive everything, go check out my media management video. I walk through my full system over there. So that's my workflow, from idea to upload. I use ChatGPT to brainstorm, polish scripts, and come up with titles and thumbnails. Link takes care of all the boring A-roll editing, so I don't have to scrub through hours of footage. Apple Motion gives me full creative control anytime I need a custom title or animation. Afonic cleans and masters my audio so everything sounds crisp and consistent. Architect helps me clean up and archive my projects once a video is done. And of course, Final Cut Pro for everything else. None of these tools replace the creative part of the process, but they save me time, make everything smoother, and lets me focus on making better videos. If you got any questions about how I use these, drop them in the comments. And if you want to check out any of the tools I mentioned, I've linked them all in the description below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.